Chairman Casey, Ranking Member Rich, distinguished members of the committee, Senator Lugar, thank you for inviting us to appear before you today to discuss our goals with regard to Syria and the strategy that we are implementing to achieve them. Bashar al-Assad is destroying Syria and destabilizing the region. As Secretary Clinton said 2 days ago, the greatest source of instability in the region is not people's legitimate demands for change, it is the refusal to change. An orderly democratic transition that removes Assad from power and restores stability is clearly in the United States' interest, as it is in the interest of the Syrian people. It will support our goals of promoting democracy and human rights, contribute to greater stability in the region, and undermine Iran's influence. Our message to President Assad can be summed up briefly. Step aside and allow your people to begin a transition to democracy. Though we would like to see this transition proceed as quickly as possible, we should be prepared for the process, unfortunately, to be long and difficult. Much has already changed since the unrest began 8 months ago. Internally, a large and growing number of Syrians have concluded that Assad must go. Protests that started in the remote village of Dara now take place in nearly every city and major town in the country. For the regime to retain power, the Syrian army has had to occupy its own country. But the regime's overwhelming use of force has not been able to suppress Syria's courageous street protesters demanding their universal rights. And internationally, Syria is increasingly isolated as the international community loses patience with Assad's brutality and broken promises. Nearly all of Syria's neighbors now recognize that Assad is dangerously fomenting instability. And that's why we see this unusual Arab League leadership on a country that's considered to be very important politically and strategically in the Arab world. The Arabs want Assad to stop destroying Syria. The Gulf Cooperation Council described the regime as, quote, a killing machine. After several years of strengthening ties with Syria, Turkish Prime Minister Erdogan said, quote, those who repress their own people in Syria will not survive. Totalitarian regimes are disappearing. The rule of the people is coming. The coverage of the regime's brutality in pan-Arab media has also destroyed Assad's standing in the Arab street. He has become a pariah in the Arab world. Almost all the Arab leaders, the foreign ministers who I talk to, say the same thing. Assad's rule is coming to an end. It is inevitable. Some of these Arabs have even begun to offer Assad safe haven to encourage him to leave quickly. We welcome the efforts of the Arab League to stop the violence, but the regime must be judged by its actions, not by its words. The killing, as you said, Mr. Chairman, has continued unabated, and we urge our Arab partners to condemn the regime and assume a greater role in building international pressure, including at the UN. Economically, tough US and EU sanctions and financial mismanagement by the Syrian regime are changing the calculus of Syria's business elite. Oil revenue is now almost non-existent. The regime's assets in the United States and European banks have been frozen, and Syria is cut off from most of the international financial system. As cash starts to dry up, more Syrians see that the regime is not sustainable. Complementing our international efforts, Ambassador Ford, as you mentioned, both of you mentioned, and his team are doing courageous work. And thank you to this committee for confirming him. He's currently in the United States on leave, and we expect to return to post soon. Overall, we are following a deliberative course that takes into account Syria's unique circumstances. We do not want to see the situation descend into further violence. The best way forward is to continue support for the nonviolent opposition while working with international partners to further isolate, to further pressure the regime. This creates an environment in which the Syrians can take control of their own future. You mentioned the Syrian National Council. We welcome the establishment of the Syrian National Council, a broad coalition of opposition groups from inside and outside Syria. When you consider that for the past 40 years, Syrians have been prevented from engaging in any political activity, what the opposition has already achieved is truly remarkable. We the United States, have not endorsed any particular opposition group. The Syrian people alone will decide who can legitimately represent them. The opposition must continue to expand and consolidate its base within Syria by convincing more Syrians of the legitimacy of its vision and its transition plan, which demonstrates that there's a better alternative to Assad. While we understand the Syrian people's need to protect themselves, violent resistance is counterproductive. It will play into the regime's hands, it will divide the opposition, it will undermine international consensus. To create better protection for civilians in the near term, we're pressing for access to human rights monitors and journalists. We will relentlessly pursue our strategy of supporting the opposition and diplomatically and financially pressuring the regime until Assad is gone and until the Syrians are able to complete their democratic transition. Assad may, through his brutality, be able to delay or impede this transition, but he cannot stop it. We look forward to working with the Syrian people as they chart a new and democratic future.